Good morning, students. In this session, today we are going to see Unit 4, Symmetry. Students, listen carefully. Make a note of each and every important points in your Max classwork note. If you have any doubt, make a note of it. The doubts will be clarified on the reopening day. Students, now let's see mathematics alive in symmetry. Students, looking at our surroundings, we see that most of the objects appear with certain beauty. Do you know why these objects look beautiful? The balanced harmony at a perfect ratio makes these objects look beautiful. This kind of organized pattern is called symmetry. Symmetry plays a vital role in many fields of work like making toys, drawings, columns, household goods, manufacturing vehicles, construction of buildings. Now let's see the learning objectives of symmetry. To identify symmetrical objects in our surroundings. To understand the types of symmetry. Now let's see what is meant by symmetry. Students, in mathematics, a meaning of symmetry defines that one shape is exactly like the other shape when it is moved, rotated or flipped. Students, symmetry in nature. Divide the leaf in half and you will find that the shape of one half is same as the other. Butterfly. Butterfly will be divided by one line of symmetry. Therefore, line symmetry divides an object into equal parts. Students, symmetric objects are found all around us in nature, architecture and art. Do you know the word symmetry comes from the Greek word symmetros, which means having a common measure. Symmetry is having one side that exactly mirrors the others. A line of symmetry divides a symmetrical shape in half. An object may have more than one line of symmetry. See, lines of symmetry. For square, it has four lines of symmetry. Line of symmetry is nothing but it basically divides an object into two mirror image halves. The line of symmetry can be vertical, horizontal or diagonal. There may be one or more lines of symmetry. Lines of symmetry. See this, a square has four lines of symmetry and a rectangle has two lines of symmetry. Rhombus has two lines of symmetry. Kite has one line of symmetry. An isosceles trapezoid has one line of symmetry. Trapezoid has no lines of symmetry. Parallelogram. Parallelogram has no lines of symmetry. An equilateral triangle has three lines of symmetry. And an isosceles triangle has one line of symmetry. For better understanding, see this image. The first tree divides two equal halves. So it is called as symmetric. But here the line does not divide it into two equal halves. So it is not a line of symmetry. It is called as asymmetric. See this butterfly. It divides into two equal parts. So it is a symmetry. Students, symmetry can be found anywhere in nature as well as in man-made objects. A few of them are leaves, insects, flowers, animals, notebooks, bottles, architecture, designs and shapes. Students, keep in mind, a line of symmetry in a square is 4. A line of symmetry in a square is 4. Because a square divides into 4 equal parts. Therefore, a square has 4 lines of symmetry. Lines of symmetry in a triangle. It has three lines of symmetry. It divides into three equal parts. So a triangle has three lines of symmetry. Students, a figure may have 1, 2, 3 or more lines of symmetry or no line of symmetry. Now let's see what is mean by rotational symmetry. We have already learnt about rotation. Rotation means turning around a center. The position after 90 degree, see the square. The position after 90 degree is this. And the position after 180 degree, it rotates like this. The position after 270 degree, it turns like this. And the position after 360 degree is? Yes. Again, the same image will appear. When one rotation is completed, the rotating object comes back to the position where it started. During a complete rotation, the object moves through 360 degree. Students, keep in mind, when one rotation is completed, the rotation object comes back to the position where it started. During a complete rotation, the object moves through 360 degree. See this rectangle. The initial position of this rectangle is like this. After turning the rectangle, the position after 90 degree turn is like this. And the position after 180 degree is like this. And the position after 270 degree is like this. And the position after 360 degree turn is like this. During a complete rotation, the object moves through 360 degree. The rotating object comes back to the position where it started when it moves through 360 degree. Now let's see what is mean by order of rotational symmetry. Students, order of rotation is nothing but the total number of times a figure coincides with itself in one complete rotation is called the order of rotational symmetry. See this rectangle. The complete rotation of rectangle is 360 degree. The position after 360 degree turn is like this. Before that, when you turn 180 degree, you will get the real image of the rectangle. Therefore, how many times it shows the real image? Yes, two times. Students, see this picture. The initial position of the rectangle is like this. After rotating the rectangle in 90 degree, the position of the rectangle is like this. And after rotating the rectangle in 180 degree, we get the initial position of the rectangle. And again, after rotating the rectangle in 360 degree, the initial position of the rectangle appears. Therefore, two times the rectangle matches exactly the same in full rotation. Students, let's see one more example. If you rotate the alphabet B in 90 degree, 180 degree, 270 degree and 360 degree, that is one complete rotation. After rotating the alphabet B in 360 degree turn, we get the initial position of the letter B. See this. The position after 90 degree turn is like this. And the position after 180 degree turn is like this. It is not the initial position of the letter B. But after rotating the letter B in 360 degree, we get the initial position. So, the order of rotation of this image is 1. Students, now let's see a line of symmetry in alphabets. Students, keep in mind, the line of symmetry can be vertical, horizontal or slant. See this. In a letter A, it has vertical line of symmetry. That is one line symmetry. In a letter B, it has horizontal line of symmetry. And similar for C, D and E. F has no line of symmetry because it cannot be divided into two equal parts. And the letter G has also no line of symmetry. H and I has two line of symmetry. It has both the vertical and horizontal line of symmetry. J has no line of symmetry and K has one line of symmetry with horizontal. L has no line of symmetry and M has vertical line of symmetry. N has no line of symmetry and O has two line of symmetry, both the vertical and horizontal. And the letter P, Q, R, S and Z are all has no line of symmetry. And the letter T, U, V, W and Y has one line of symmetry. And the letter X has two line of symmetry. Students, how many lines of symmetry in the letter A? Yes, one line of symmetry. And it is similar for B and C. The line of symmetry can be vertical, horizontal or slant. Now let's see what is meant by reflection symmetry. Students, reflection symmetry is nothing but it is a type of symmetry in which one half of the object reflects the other half of the object. It is also called as mirror symmetry or line of symmetry. Students, already we know that a line of symmetry divides the figure into two equal halves. When you keep a mirror along the line of symmetry, the other half of the figure gets reflected by the mirror and it looks the same. This is known as reflection symmetry or mirror symmetry. A shape has reflection symmetry if it has a line of symmetry. See this object. A triangle reflects like this. And similarly, the letter P reflects like this. The mirror image of the letter P is like this. A letter A, H and I look the same in the mirror because they have lines of symmetry. When an object is seen in a mirror, the image obtained on the other side of the mirror is called its reflection. See this. The following figure shows the reflection of the picture. Students, we observe that an object and its mirror image are symmetrical with reference to the mirror line. If the paper is folded, the mirror line becomes the line of symmetry. Students, noted the object and its image will lie at the same distance from the mirror. The only difference is that the left side is on the right side and vice versa. Now let's see what is meant by translation symmetry. If the object is translated or moved from one position to another, the same orientation in the forward and the backward motion is called translation symmetry. In other words, it is defined as a sliding of an object about an axis. This can be observed clearly from the figure given below. See, the shape is moved forward and backward in the same orientation by keeping the fixed axis. Here, a particular pattern or design is continued throughout. The pattern changes its place without rotation or reflection. The exact image is found without changing its orientation. Thus, translation symmetry occurs when a pattern slides to a new position. The sliding moment involves neither rotation nor reflection. Example 1. Draw the lines of symmetry for the given figures and also find the number of lines of symmetry. Students, first you have to draw the line of symmetry for the given figures and you have to find the number of lines of symmetry. First you have to draw the line of symmetry. Students, as you already know that what is meant by line of symmetry? Yes, if the line divides into two equal halves, then it is called as line of symmetry. See this. It divides into two equal parts in horizontal and vertical. So, the number of lines of symmetry is 2. Now let's find for this arrow. Only one line of symmetry. Therefore, the number of lines of symmetry is 1. We cannot divide into vertical line, because in this only we have the arrows. In this side there is no arrows. So if we divide like this, means it cannot divide into two equal parts. So there is only one line of symmetry. And for rhombus, one, then two. In rhombus, it has two lines of symmetry. First, you have to draw the line of symmetry. Then you have to count and write the number of lines of symmetry. Example 3. Draw the lines of symmetry for an equilateral triangle, a square, a regular pentagon and a regular hexagon, and also find the number of lines of symmetry. Students, first you have to draw the line of symmetry for this figure. Triangle, square, pentagon and hexagon. Students, as you already know that a triangle has three lines of symmetry. One is vertical and then is two slanting lines. Therefore, a triangle has three lines of symmetry. An equilateral triangle has three lines of symmetry. And then you have to find the number of lines of symmetry for a square. A square has four lines of symmetry. See, one is horizontal line and vertical line and then two slanting lines. It divides equally two parts. See, one, then two equal parts. See, this two slanting lines. Therefore, we have four lines of symmetry in a square. A square has four lines of symmetry. And then you have to find the lines of symmetry for a regular pentagon. A pentagon has five lines of symmetry. See this vertical line and then two slanting lines. And again here two slanting lines. Therefore, totally a regular pentagon has five lines of symmetry. A regular pentagon has five lines of symmetry. And then let's find for a regular hexagon. A lines of symmetry for the shape hexagon. First one vertical line, then horizontal line, then slanting lines. Therefore, totally a regular hexagon has six lines of symmetry. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. A regular hexagon has six lines of symmetry. Students, keep in mind, the number of lines of symmetry of each regular polygon, that is a closed figure having equal and equal angles, is equal to the number of sides. For example, an equilateral triangle has three sides. Therefore, an equilateral triangle has three lines of symmetry. See, in square, it has four sides. And a square has four lines of symmetry. A number of lines of symmetry is equal to the number of sides. See, for pentagon, it has 5 equal sides and it has also 5 lines of symmetry. A hexagon has 6 sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it also has 6 lines of symmetry. So, if it is a closed figure having equal sides and equal angles means the number of lines of symmetry is equal to number of sides. Example 5. Assuming one shape is the reflection of the other, draw the mirror line for each of the given figures. Students, you have to assume one shape is a reflection of the other. See, the reflection of L is like this. You have to draw the mirror line for each of the given figures. See, if we draw the mirror line like this means it is not correct because the mirror image of L is like this. So, you have to draw the mirror line like this. See, the mirror image of L is like this. Similarly, you have to draw the mirror line for this rectangle also. See, if you draw the line like this means it is not a mirror line. It is like a line of symmetry. If you draw like this means it is also line of symmetry. But if you draw the line like this means it is a mirror line. See here, the mirror image of this rectangle is like this. Students, in question, if they are asking to draw the mirror line means you have to draw like this. Suppose in question, if they are asking to find the lines of symmetry means you have to find the lines of symmetry like this by drawing the horizontal and vertical line. But to draw the mirror line, you have to draw like this. If you put the line and check the mirror image of L is like this or not, and the mirror image of rectangle is like this. Example 6. Draw the reflection image of the following figures above the given line. See, you have to draw the mirror image of this letter P, triangle and look. See, if you have any doubt, check within your mirror. Show the letter P in the mirror. It shows like this. And the mirror image of triangle is like this. And the mirror image of L is yes. It looks like this. And the mirror image of look is like this. Students, try it in your home. See all the alphabet letters in the mirror and write it in your max note. Example 10. A man hole cover of a water sump is in square shape. First one, in how many ways we can fix that to close the sump? And second one, what is its order of rotational symmetry? See here, the given question is a manhole cover a water sump is in the square shape. We have to find in how many ways we can fix that to close the sum and the order of rotational symmetry. See, the initial position of the square shape water sump is like this. The initial position of a square is like this. A, B, C, D. See, the initial position of a water sump is like this. And then we have to rotate it into 90 degree. Then it becomes like this. The arrow will change this into yes, like this. If we rotate the square like this means it will change like this. Then it becomes A, B, C and D. If we rotate the square shaped water sump into 90 degree means it will change into A, D, C, B. And again we have to rotate into 180 degree angle. Then it becomes like this. A, D, C, then B. If we rotate the square shaped water sump into 90 degree means it will becomes like this.
And 180 degree means it will become like this.
And then 270 degree. Yes. A, B, C, D. A, D, C, B.
And again in 360 degree. After rotating the square shaped water sump into 360 degree, we get the initial position. So,
we can fix it in four ways. How many ways? 1, 2, 3 and then 4. So, we can fix it in 4 ways. 90 degree, 180 degree, 270 degree and 360 degree. The initial position of the square
shaped water sump is like this. After rotating the square shaped water sump into 90 degree, we will get like this. And in 180 degree, we will get like this. And in 270 degree, the shape of the square sump like this. And in 360 degree, again you get the initial position of the square sump.
Then you have to find the order of rotational symmetry. The order of rotational symmetry is 4.
Because after rotating it into 90, 270, 180 and 360 degree, you will get the initial position of the square. See here, after rotating 90 degree, we will get the same initial position of the square sum. After rotating into 180 degree, we get the same initial position of the square sum. It is similar for 270 degree and 360 degree. So the order of rotation is 1, 2, 3 and 4.
Order of rotation is nothing but the total number of times a figure coincides with itself in one complete rotation is called an order of rotational symmetry.
Example 14. Which pattern is translated in the given columns?
See here, the pattern is given. You have to find the translation symmetry. Translation symmetry is nothing but a pattern slides to a new position. The sliding movement involves neither rotation or reflection. See here, the pattern is given. Which pattern is translated in given columns?
Yes.
The first pattern is like this. This pattern is gets to form a column. Second one. Which pattern is translated in the given column?
Yes.
1, 2, 3. 3 dots. And then you have to draw the pattern like this. This pattern continues to form a column. Students, it is nothing but a particular pattern or design is continued throughout. The pattern changes its place without rotation or reflection. See here, this pattern continues here throughout the design. The exact image is found without changing its orientation. See, in this also the exact image continues without changing its orientation.
Let's see today's activity. First one, write the numbers from 0 to 9. Which numbers have a line of symmetry and list of the numbers which do not have a line of symmetry?